We're gathered here today to see our final farewells to our friend, father, grandfather, great-grandfather, and especially someone that used to love to come to Sacred Heart, to come to church. This was like his second home. So if you would help me say the rosary, I'll say the Hail Marys, you'll say the Holy Ones, and this way we make Max proud. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. We'll say three Hail Marys for the increase of faith, hope, and love. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins. Save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. The first glorious mystery is the resurrection. The angel said to the woman, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are seeking Jesus the crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised as he said. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven." Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Almighty Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. The second glorious mystery is this ascension. As the apostles were looking on, Jesus was lifted up on a cloud, took him from their sight. This Jesus who has been taken up from you into heaven will return in the same way as you have seen him going into heaven. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Almighty Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. The third glorious mystery is the descent of the Holy Spirit. When the time for Pentecost was fulfilled, they were all in one place together. And suddenly there came from the sky a noise like a strong driving wind, and it filled the entire house in which they were. Then there appeared to them tongues as the fire, which parted and came to rest on each one of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Almighty Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. The fourth glorious mystery is the Assumption. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with us those who have fallen asleep. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. The fourth glorious mystery is the coronation. A great sign appeared in the sky, a woman clothed with the sun, with the moon under her feet, and on her head a crown of 12 stars. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To you do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To you we send up our sighs, mourning, and weeping this valley of tears. Turn, our most gracious advocate, thine eyes of mercy towards us. And after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of your womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. O God, whose only begotten Son, by his life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us rewards of eternal life, grant, we beseech thee, that by meditating upon the mysteries of the Most Holy Rosary of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may imitate what they contain and obtain what they promise, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto Max, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen. May his soul and all the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I want to let everybody know that there are the bathrooms are over here to the left when you go, so you don't have to go out of the building. You know. And now I invite Danielle Little to come and do the eulogy.
Okay, thank you. Good morning. On behalf of our family, I'd like to thank you all for coming today to celebrate my dad's life. Dad was born on October 7th, 1936 to Louis and Rebecca Madrill. He had a big, wonderful family. My mother told me that one of the reasons she married Dad was because of how he treated his mother so nicely, and she loved that trait about him. He had so much love and pride for his family. Family and home were so important to Dad. He always wanted to be home, and home meant different things to him, such as family. Dad had a great military career, something he was very proud of. We all are very proud of that. He was in the Army, came back to Alamosa, re-enlisted into the Navy, and retired after serving his country for decades. After retiring, he and Mom wanted to come back to Colorado. Mom always says she had hoped that it would be Denver, but Dad heard Colorado and came straight back to Alamosa. He wanted to come home and have us be raised near our grandparents and aunts and uncles and family, and all of you here in Alamosa. Dominic remembers that when we were in the process of moving from California to Colorado, that he and Dad were going to stay at Uncle Leroy's house for a night, and Uncle Leroy's girlfriend got mad, and so Dad and he had to buy sleeping bags and a sterno for light, and they got to have a camping experience at the house that already had all the electricity shut off, and then they drove straight through to their new home in Alamosa. As an adult, I realized the gift that decision to move to Alamosa was. While we were growing up, we were so blessed with always being around family. Grandma Becky and Grandpa Lewis came by to have tea and cookies while we ate dinner in the evenings. And I can still hear Grandma saying, "Just in time for supper," and Grandpa saying, "Boy, it smells like Grandma, or it smells like Barbara burned the chili again." Dad wanted us to be around family, and he wanted Alamosa to be our home, so he made sure that we moved here and we could be near my mom's dad, Grandpa Phil, along with Aunt Paula and Rochelle as well. You all know Dad was very military and structured. However, he was always there watching the chaos and the shenanigans, usually caused by Uncle Greg and Uncle Lionel, with a smile and a smirk on his face. Aunt Geo said that he was always there in the background observing and chuckling, and how it reminded her so much of their dad, Grandpa Lewis. Dad wanted us to be a part of every family activity. We were there at baptisms, birthdays, holidays, weddings, camping trips, and he just made sure we were always a part of family. Another example of his military routine was when Uncle Jim remembers that he and Nikki had a routine when they lived in Castle Rock. They would come and see Mom and Dad, spend a few hours there, and then head to Lahana for a few hours. And the routine was that they would always be at Dad's by 8 a.m. sharp. Uncle Jim said that on one of those trips, they took a little bit longer and arrived at 8:05. And there was Dad, on his military time, pacing up and down the road looking for them. And the first words he said to Uncle Jim was, "You're late. What happened?" Dad and Uncle Rich talked on every Saturday afternoon like clockwork. And those talks meant the world to Dad, and I'm sure they meant the world to Uncle Rich as well. I know that there were times I would tell Dad that I was going to call him on Saturday, and he said, "Wait till after church," because Uncle Rich and I talked before church. So that routine and that constant connection, Uncle Rich will miss that with Dad. When I first started dating Chris, he was talking about dating me to someone in town, and this person laughed and said, "Good luck, you're dating Mad Max's daughter." Well, it grew from that Mad Max relationship with my dad and Chris, to him asking me regularly, "What does Chris think I should do?" Chris made a comment today or this week that stuck with me. He said, "I'm here to support you, but you have to remember he's been my family for almost 35 years as well." I asked his grandkids to share some memories that I'd like to share with you. Justin remembers living there with his dad while Dominic was finishing up his teaching certificate at Adams State. And he said he always remembers Dad sitting in his recliner eating peanuts. Melissa remembers playing board games with Grandpa. She also remembered him taking her to Walmart when she was young and her talking him into buying her a new outfit, something that was her favorite outfit for a very long time. Marky remembered watching The Price is Right with him. He said he remembers Grandpa was always looking for a way to help people out. He would hire somebody to do stuff around the house just because that person needed a job and money. He said he remembers how much Grandpa loved Alamosa, and even when he was traveling, he missed it and wanted to be back home. Grandma would come visit for a month, but Grandpa, we got 1 week usually out of Dad. Courtney said she remembers how much he loved Alamosa and his house. He took that house and fixed it up to be what it is today with two porches, one on the front and one on the back, new tile, new carpet. He remodeled that kitchen. He was pretty proud of that house, and she remembers that the yard was beautiful, especially when Grandma was gardening. Taylor remembered driving around and sitting on the tractor with Grandpa while he was cleaning up the yard, and also the 1 year when they were visiting, he let them and the boys paint the shed, and then they painted it pink. Brendan was remembering with how every summer him and Michael and Courtney and Taylor would convince Grandpa into getting a new water slide to play on. He bought him one every year when they were little, and they would play on it until it broke and it was ruined, and then they would convince him again the next year to buy him one, even though he had said, "This is the last one I'm buying you." Michael said he remembered Grandpa always had candy hidden. When he was little, he would sneak into his room and take some from his dresser. Grandma and Grandpa always said if something was missing, Michael probably knew where it was because he had been looking for candy. He loved us all so much. His children, his grandchildren, his siblings, his nieces and nephews, and all of you here. While I sat with him in his final moments, I let him know how much he was loved by his family. Joanna wanted to FaceTime him to tell him how special their time in Utah was her. He had voicemails from Uncle Jim, Uncle Rich, Aunt Becky, and Aunt Geo, and I played them throughout the night so that he could hear all of your voices and know how much you were loved by him. I also played him Taylor singing De Colores, which was Grandma Becky's favorite song, and How Great Thou Art that she had sang. And I also played Raise You Up on Eagle's Wings, which is special to our family as well. John Richard called me that morning, and I put him on speakerphone, and he told Dad that Captain Madrill was going to come and make sure that his shoes were shined. At that time, we heard a flyover from Luke Air Force Base, and I told Dad, "Look, John Richard organized a flyover of the Angels to take you home to the Angels." It took a while, but he started to enjoy the people around him at the assisted living facility in Surprise. But it was not home. Everything he did in that facility was to find a magical fix to get him back to Alamosa. He wanted new shoes so that he could walk, and he wanted braces to help him stand and be stable so that he could be back here at home and go to church and live in his house and be at home in Alamosa. One of the caregivers came in after he passed and asked if she could pay her respects. She asked if we were taking him home to Colorado. And when I said yes, she said, "Oh, good, he's getting to go back home." I told her that he would be laid to rest next to my mom. She said, "I'm so glad to hear that," because he had told her how wonderful Alamosa was. He told her it was hard to explain, but that Alamosa is family and everybody cares for you, and it always feels like you're at home with the people around you. She said he described it as familia, donde la vida comienza y el amor nunca termina, which means family, where life begins and love never ends. Alamosa and family was home to Dad. I'm glad that when Dad called him home, he was able to join our loved ones that passed before us. I am glad that we were able to honor him with a Mass at Sacred Heart Church, which has been a church and part of our family for decades. As I look out at all of you and the love and the support that we have received from all of my family and my friends, I am blessed. All of you here with us today, along with the numerous phone calls and the loved ones who wanted so badly to be here and are here in spirit, I am reminded of how Dad spent his entire life showing us that family and home is everything. Thank you for being a part of my family and our home. Rest in peace, Daddy. We all love you and you are home. And I'm going to play How Great Thou Art, which was a song sung by Taylor.
Christ shall come with shouts of acclamation and take me home, with joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and then proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God. How great thou art, and sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art, how great thou art, how great thou art.
Thank you again for being my family. I love you all.
Again, we welcome you to Sacred Heart Church. I'm Father Carlos Alvarez, pastor. In the waters of baptism, Maximino died and rose with Christ. May he now share with him eternal glory.
You who dwell in the shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life, say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock in whom I trust, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. The snare of the fowler will never capture you, and famine will bring you no feed. Under his wings, your refuge, his faithfulness, your shield. and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on breath of dawn, make beauty shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. Let us pray. O God, who have set a limit to this present life so as to open up an entry into eternity, we humbly beseech you that by the grace of your mercy, you may command the name of your servant Max to be inscribed in the book of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. I invite you to be seated as Mark and our other reader come forward, please.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For in the eyes of men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with the elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
He will be my shepherd. Nothing more shall I want. He leads me along the path of right, according to his word. The Lord, he will be my shepherd. Nothing more shall I want. In valleys of green, he lets me lie. To restful waters, he leads me. If ever I walk in darkness,
Nothing more would I fear. There at my side you will stand. Your staff will give me courage. The banquet you set before me, under the eyes of my foes, and over my head you pour your oil. My cup is flowing over. Your love will be always with me every day of my life. My home will be in my Lord's house as long as the Lord, he will be my shepherd. Nothing more shall I want. He leads me along the path of right, according to his word.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Alabanza a ti, O Cristo, Rey de eterna gloria. If today you hear his voice, harden not your heart. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory be to you.
Jesus answered the Jews and said to them, Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever hears my word and believes in the one who sent me has eternal life and will not come to condemnation, but is passed from death to life. Amen, amen, I say to you, the hour is coming and is now here when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God. And those who hear will live. For just as the Father has life in himself, so also he gave to his Son the possession of life in himself. And he gave him the power to exercise judgment, because he is the Son of man. Do not be amazed at this, because the hour is coming in which all who are in the tombs will hear his voice and will come out. Those who have done good deeds to the resurrection of life, but those who have done wicked deeds to the resurrection of condemnation. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
See where Eli is, our wonderful funeral director. In justice, I should be standing there and giving this funeral homily from there. You may be seated. That's where your daddy sat when he was by himself. He'd come up the ramp, sit there, bring his walker the last few times. He'd sit there, and we'd take him Holy Communion. And because he didn't want to be trampled with the buffalo stampede at the end of Mass, he'd leave after communion to be safe. So I was unaware that he was back in Phoenix, that he had fallen, and we got the sad notice about 10 days ago that his Mass of Christian burial would be today. So your daddy was the first person I visited when I came to Alamosa as pastor, February 2021. And went into the house and visited and celebrated a couple sacraments, and including the anointing of the sick and giving him Holy Communion. And he shared the story with me. He said, you know, that he and your mom often brought the gifts of bread and wine forward during the Saturday anticipated Mass, and that they'd just done that for a long time. And one time, Father Bill Gleason came back to substitute for the pastor who was here at the time. And when they brought the gifts forward, Father Gleason said to him, "Something's never changed." He was a rock. He was steadfast in his love, as you said beautifully in the homily, of family and home. And that was probably deeply rooted in his love of God, this his spiritual home, this his spiritual family. Lived out beautifully with all of you, his children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, all of his family and friends. So when we know that this was your father, grandfather, great-grandfather, uncle, brother's life, we know that that's the life that we're called to. It's the life that all of us are called to. From the moment we're baptized, represented by the Paschal candle and this white pall, from the moment we're baptized to the moment that God calls us home, we're to live out that love of God in our family and in our home. And he did it beautifully, wonderfully. So that's what sacred scripture reminds us of today. That's why we're gathered here in hope. We're sad for ourselves. We miss him, and we'll miss him. But we're hopeful about his reunion with the family in the heavenly home. That's why we're here, to pray for that reality, for that promise. So we think about what we heard in sacred scripture. The hour has not yet come, Jesus says in today's gospel. St. John, when he talks about the hour, he's talking about the hour of Jesus' passion and death, okay? The Jewish belief was that cursed is the one who hangs on a tree. So there was no worse death than to be crucified. Yet Jesus knew that he would be crucified. A couple days from today, on Sunday, or even tomorrow afternoon, tomorrow evening, when Max would normally come, we'll be celebrating Palm Sunday. We'll be starting the holiest week of the year. We'll remember Jesus' passion and death, and Jesus will be placed in the tomb on Palm Sunday. But then, 1 week later, after the great celebrations of Holy Thursday and Good Friday and the Easter Vigil, we'll celebrate the Lord's resurrection that holy night, Easter Vigil, and Easter Sunday. And this is what we hear in the gospel. The resurrection to life. The resurrection for all of our good deeds. I didn't know of a bad deed from this man. I didn't know one bad deed of this man. I know he was human and he made mistakes, but no one ever came to me and I never saw any bad deeds. I just saw goodness from this man. And so we're standing here and that promise of resurrection, that promise of life that Jesus gave to us by his own passion, by his own death, by his own resurrection, that we all share in because of baptism and confirmation and the Eucharist and holy matrimony and all the sacraments, all the sacraments. And we hear about that care in our first reading from the Book of Wisdom. His care is with his elect. The elect is another name that the church uses for those who are preparing for the Easter mysteries, those who receive those sacraments of initiation. Though this was in the context of the Jewish faith, it applies beautifully in the Christian tradition as well. So that care that Jesus has for us begins in the sacraments and continues on through that love that flows from him through the sacraments to our family, in our home. And that's the role of every man. Every man, like Saint Joseph, is called to protect his family, to provide for his family, and to be the spiritual head of the family. And he was. And I can understand, you know, the world looks so much better in Denver, Colorado than perhaps Alamosa in the eyes of the world. But you know, living and serving here in Alamosa with my great-grandmother having been born in the valley, I understand that though in the eyes of the world, Alamosa doesn't seem like the destination, it's where family and home were for him. And so the reality is we make family and home wherever we are, Colorado Springs, Phoenix, wherever in the world we live, family and home, God is there. God is with us. St. Paul in his letter to the Romans said, are you unaware that we who have been baptized into Christ have been baptized into his death? The death is a reality, a death that we cannot escape. It was his time for death earlier this month. But that death is just a stage. We had our chrism mass for all the priests this past Tuesday. And Bishop Berg, Bishop of our Diocese of Pueblo, said that in his 9 years as bishop, he's had 19 change of addresses for priests. That is, they've gone from earth to heaven. How? Through death. Through death. Like all of us. We have to experience death. But it's a change of address. The pastor who was here previously said, they have a new zip code. His new zip code's in heaven. That's what we're here for. That's what we remember. That's what we celebrate. Yes, we mourn. Yes, we're sad. We're heartbroken. But he's on his way to heaven. He's on his way to heaven. That's what Jesus suffered and died and rose for. And that's what we believe. And that's how we live. And that's what we do everything we can in terms of family and home to create that heavenly-like love so that it's not anything new or different. It's just a continuation in a glorious way of a grace-filled reality on earth. So, okay, Eli, I have to preach from here, not there, but you're sitting in the perfect spot to honor Max, and we're all in this perfect place to honor Max because he did live that love of God as a man, as a husband, as a father, as a grandfather, as a brother in the Lord. And so, though we're sad, we're happy for him and the promise of heaven, where God's love and glory are in its fullness. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end.
Amen. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church, confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus. We join our prayers to his.
In baptism, Max received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Our brother Max was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all those whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
The family and friends of Max seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our brother Max. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
I invite you to be seated as our altar is prepared.
Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of death. Amen. Gentle woman, quiet light, morning star, so strong and bright. Gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love. You were chosen by the Father. Chosen for the Son, you were chosen from all women, and for woman, shining one, gentle woman, quiet light, morning star, so strong and bright. Gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom. love. Blessed are you among women, blessed in turn all women too. Blessed they with peaceful spirits, blessed they with gentle hearts. Gentle woman, quiet life, morning star so strong and bright. Gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us
love. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and the glory of his name, the good and good of all his holy church.
Be near, O Lord, we pray, to your servant Max, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin have clung to him, or any human fault have affected him, it may by your loving gift be forgiven and wiped away, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For it is at your summons that we come to birth, by your will that we are governed, and at your command that we return on account of sin to that earth from which we came. And when you give the sign, we who have been redeemed by the death of your Son shall be raised up to the glory of his resurrection. And so, with a company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Santo, 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 Santo es el Señor, Dios del universo, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Oh, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in el cielo. Bendito el que viene en el nombre del Señor. Oh, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna en el cielo.
I invite able-bodied Catholics with the kneeler in front of them to kneel. Everyone else may be seated, please. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, Lord Jesus, until you come in glory, until you come in glory. Cada vez que comemos de este pan y bebemos de este cáliz, anunciamos tu muerte, Señor, hasta que vuelvas, Señor.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Therese of the Child Jesus, patroness of our diocese, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Stephen, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you've gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you've summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Maximino, whom you've called from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Jesus emptied himself of the glory of heaven. He became part of the holy family, the human family. He made this earth his home. On the sacred altar, this Eucharistic table, he offers us his body, blood, soul, and divinity, so that our family and our home, rooted in him and the triune God, may prepare us through grace for eternal glory. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will. We live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace.
Take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us. Grant us your peace. Have mercy on us. Grant us your peace.
En piedad de nosotros.
La paz, ten piedad de nosotros, danos la paz.
Again, I invite able-bodied Catholics with a kneeler in front of them to kneel, please. Everyone else may be seated. On December 31st of this past year, Pope Emeritus Benedict XVI died. He was a prolific theologian, an author. In one of his many tomes, he wrote this. And when he came to visit us as the active pontiff in 2008, he said this. He said, when you look at the stained glass windows of the church from the outside, they're broken, they're leaded, they're unappealing. But if you step into that same church with the gift of natural sunlight that we enjoy in our home state almost every day, those same windows are beautiful, inspiring, a gift. So it is to be a member of the Catholic Church. The sacrament and the altars are served for Catholics. If you're not able to receive Holy Communion today, you may still come forward to receive a blessing and to offer that blessing as a spiritual communion for the eternal happiness of the soul of Max. To receive a blessing, place your right fingers on your left shoulder and your left fingers on your right shoulder, and we will happily ask God's blessing upon you. With COVID, 3 years ago, many people stopped the practice of the faith, but today is the day that you should resume that practice in Holy Communion if that situation applies, if that scenario applies to you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Lord, you have come to the seashore
neither searching for the rich nor the wise, desiring only that I should follow. O Lord, with your eyes set upon me, gently smiling, you have spoken my name. Found by the water at your side, I will seek other shores. Lord, see my goods, my possessions. In my boat you find no power, no wealth. Accepted my nets and labor. Oh Lord, with your eyes set upon me, gently smiling, you have spoken my name. All I long for, I have found by the water at your side, and seek other shore. Lord, take my hands and direct them. Help me spend myself in seeking the lost. Returning love for the love you gave me. Oh Lord, with your eyes set upon me, gently smiling, you have spoken my name. All I long for, I have found by the water at your side, I will seek other shores. Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true, with thanksgiving. I'll be a living sanctuary for you. Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true, with thanksgiving. I'll be a living sanctuary for you.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant Max, who has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Trusting in God, we pray together for Maximino. And now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Max again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
Que los ángeles del cielo te encuentren y te lleven al paraíso del Señor. Que los ángeles del cielo te encuentren y los santos y los mártires también. Que los ángeles en coro te reciban en la vida santa de Jerusalén. Y con Lázaro, pobre en esta vida, tengas el descanso eterno con Dios. Que los ángeles del cielo te encuentren y te lleven ante el trono del Señor. Que los mártires y santos te bendigan y te dé la vida eterna el Señor. Que los ángeles en coro te reciban en la vida santa de Jerusalén. Y con Lázaro, pobre en esta vida, tengas el descanso eterno con Dios. Tengas el descanso eterno con Dios.
Let us pray. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Max, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Max in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Thanks be to
God. Amen. In peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.
Thanks be to God.
Oh, amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved and set me free. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Was grace that taught my I'll pray.